see Abakan. Yerevan, Yerevan, Hushatsan, Hakutian, Hayyamki, Haylesvi, Bahavan. Արևցես, հարգելի բարեկամներ, հայ ժողովրդի բարեկամներ անշուշտ, միևնույն ժամանակ YouTube-ի հաճախորդներ եւ ընկերներ Facebook-ից։ Բարևներ, այսօր ունիմ երկու հյուրեր եւ տարիներ է եւ ճանաչում ենք իրար։ Հիմա ես տեսնում եք, ես Լոս Անջելեսը հայրեն եմ խոսում, խոսեմ Գոր Եղերգոր, այնպես որ ուրախ եմ, քիչ վկարջ պիտի գաղապեմ, որպեսի պասադրեմ, թե ովքեր են աստեղ։ Welcome to Armenian Classic TV.
Thank you, Sarki. It's been a pleasure again to see you.
Thank you.
And thank you for always being a hero for the Armenian people and preserving their music, their history, and also all of our culture. You've been a great inspiration. I know you now for almost 40 years, and you've done a marvelous job for the Armenian community in and around California. So thank you.
Yep, Anantat Gasharunagas.
And we will
Chesarnesh.
Yes.
By the way, your friend Fresno, you know, one time they used to call us Fresno Indians.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, I was at the border once coming from 50 years ago, maybe.
Oh, absolutely.
He was looking to the cars, he looked at me, oh, Fresno Indian, huh?
Yeah.
I thought he was putting me down, that I saw what it means.
Well, it was a put down. It was a put down at the time.
Yeah.
But the Armenians, like any other immigrant group, suffered indignation from the people that lived there. It's always been a problem. Armenians couldn't buy homes in certain areas.
You know, I admire it also because you speak also Armenian.
Yes.
Of course, you were born in Fresno, right?
No, I was born in New York City.
Oh, New York.
Yes. I'll let my wife go ahead again. You want to go ahead of me?
You go.
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. My parents were born in 18. My father was born in 1896. My mother was born in 1904 in Sepasya, which is present-day Sivas, Turkey. And it's 200 miles south of the Black Sea. Yes, wow. And my parents escaped the many horrors of the Armenian genocide, and their story is a film by itself, each one of them. My mother had to go through the desert of Deir Zor, and my father had escaped from Sepasya and finally got to Istanbul, and the Armenian Red Cross got his name and my mother's name and brought it to the Armenian Church on 27th Street Church in Manhattan. And when one of their relatives saw their name at the church, they sent one-way passage with the Armenian Red Cross and the Near East Foundation to bring my parents to the United States.
All right.
Yeah.
How about Barbara?
Well, my great-grandparents came to the United States after the Hamidian genocide in 1895-96. So Hazar Utahir Inusun Vetsin Mets Mamas Vetstariganov Vekav Anur Mamain Head. Եվ ապրեցանք ու շարունակեցինք, եւ ես 4-րդ սերունդ կլամ աս երկրին մեջ, եւ շատ ուրախ եմ, աս երկիրը մեզի արի տվա, որ շարունակենք, որ ապրենք, եւ շատ ուրախ եմ։ So ես 4-րդ սերունդն եմ, հոս դնաց չէ 4-րդ սերունդ, բայց հոս ապրած 4-րդ սերունդ, եւ Սան Ֆրանցիսկո մեծած եմ, ու փոխադրվեցանք Ֆրեսնո, եւ on շարունակեցինք, մինչեւ ես ջանին ծանոթացա հայկական հարսանիտ, եւ հատեվեջ մասին ենք։
Well, ջանի միամը ժամանակ musician, I forgot to tell you, guys, Johnny is a musician.
I
also is a band leader, and we'll talk about it now a little bit.
Well, I'll just mention a few things. I graduated from New York University with a bachelor's and master's of music. And the talent scout from the Tropicana Hotel saw us playing at the Roundtable Nightclub on 50th Street and 3rd Avenue. And he liked what he saw in New York. And he said, how would you like to come and perform for a year and a half at the Tropicana Hotel? So I spoke to everybody and they agreed. And we went to the Tropicana, and then that was my beginning in Las Vegas. Right. I played there for 12 years in all the hotels and lounge shows. Mm. And then I applied for a position to teach music at the University of Las Vegas. And they accepted me, and I taught music there. And also, I started my second master's degree in education and got that at UNLV. Mm-hmm. So that's my background. Mm-hmm. And of course, I've been playing Armenian music since I'm 16 years old. The reason I got into Armenian music, because my parents were genocide survivors.
And the first song that you played was Sepastia.
No.
Sepastia.
No, I didn't do
how
that.
How old were you when you started the music? Like, what okay. made you start?
Okay. The difference is my parents told me the genocide stories of what they suffered. And they told me that because of the genocide, we have lost 75% of our Armenian culture and music. So when I thought about it growing up in my formative years, I said, I have to do something. Something inside of me said, John, you have to do something to preserve this music. So the reason I started was that the immigrant musicians that were saved and came through the Armenian genocide came to our house, and everybody in New York City was a genocide survivor.
It was at that time.
You know, I'm talking about from 1930, well, actually before that, 1926, all the way up after World War II, all were basically genocide survivors of the Armenian genocide of 1915 to 1923. And so I heard these musicians singing Armenian songs, playing Armenian songs, playing the oud, playing the clarinet, playing the dumbag, singing. Some of them would get up and dance. And some of them, while the women would see them dancing, get up with them and hug each other and start crying and laughing. So when I witnessed all of this for years and years and years, I said to my parents, you know, when I become of age, I'm going to save Armenian music the best I can. So after joining the band in high school, learning how to play clarinet, later on playing oud, I started putting a band, Armenian band together in New York City called the Highlights of New York. And we started playing weddings and picnics and dances. And that's how that whole thing started. And then, of course, when I applied to New York University for a music degree in education and music, I said, I'm going to, after I graduate, I'm going to dedicate my life in preserving Armenian music. In 1994, we established the Chookasian Armenian Concert Ensemble. And the reason I found them was because of the earthquake, a lot of the musicians came to the United States, especially Glendale and California. So I was able to put the group together. They're all conservatory graduate musicians from Armenia. And that's how it started, 1994. Mm-hmm. And we've been doing Armenian concerts in all venues.
Yeah, I remember stuff.
Well, you
some
know what?
We used to advertise, yeah.
Something that's important is that John and I are ecumenical Armenians. We are not only Western and we are not only Eastern. We're not only Amerikahais. We're not only Balsahais. We're Armenians. And we thought, you know, we hear Eastern Armenian music here, and we hear Western Armenian music here, and we need to make a bridge so that both musics are played together. So in our ensemble, that is exactly what we did. Gamuchma Astartatsink, Yev Arevelyan, Yev Arev Medyan Navaka, Nuin Pemivara. And that's our purpose.
Yev Shatkich, I mean, Harashali Hayastanyan Khumpegan. But Shatkich, Aravelyan, Yev Aramatyan, Yev Barer Gnavakin. So I think I'm Merin Hamar Shat Haduk Pamene, or Menke Stelzetsink, Yev Hamasaran Nerumech, Yegeratsinerun Hamar, Yev Azarina Har Inisuna Gedes Utin, Mer CD album Nakaka Korcharyan Lusets, Yev Beziravirets Hayastanin. Yev Meg Amis Touring Festival Nero, Yev Anshusht Concert Nero, Darpetalis Nero Mech, Yev Hayastani of Karabakh, Եվ վերջին կոնցերտը ֆիլհարմոնիկ քոլեջի մեջ կդարձավ եւ նախ եւ կուլտուրալ մինիստրը Ռոլան Շարոյանը մեզի հայկական ոսկի մեդալը մեզի դրամատրեց եւ ադիգա մեն սպարտուն է մեզի համար որ ամերիկա խումբը անշտրակները Հայաստանն են որ մեզի հարկեցին եւ ադ դվերը դվին So we were the only ones that received the gold medal of national gold medal of Armenia from the cultural minister Rola Shiroyan after our last concert on our tour at, in Yerevan, Armenia. So after that, we started playing all different types of venues throughout the United States, across America, and we toured on the East Coast, and we did a lot of things that basically no other Armenian group has done musically.
Well, I remember also in Fresno, you know, most of the Fresno at that time, it was all Turkish-style Armenian.
Aravelian.
But you were the only one, the band, that you were mixing
yes.
a little bit to keep them happy, and yes. at the same time injecting
traditional Armenian.
Yes. That was it's a job, people, they don't think, but that's the way it's supposed to be.
Yes, you're right.
And little by little, we thought, I came across Armenian songs that have never been recorded and were going to be lost. So every time we traveled overseas to Europe and to Turkey, Barbara and I were always looking for someone that knew old Armenian songs. So what we do, as soon as someone said, do you know this song? And I would say, no. So then either I would take them to the recording studio and have them sing it, or if they're a musician, play it. And I would keep the DVD as CD. And then when we came back, we started making our five albums. I only have four here.
Okay.
And we started preserving our Armenian albums.
And we would incorporate it into our concerts as well.
And of course, those songs, we would, gamats, little by little, we would incorporate into our future concerts.
Okay.
And I sent this to the Smithsonian Library. All of these now, five albums, are part of the collection of the Smithsonian Library. So any scholar from any nationality wants to do research on Armenian music, they have access to five different albums.
If they want any of these albums, how can they get it if they want it?
Well, on this program, when you have advertisements, I would like to advertise these albums, and I'll tell you a little about each one if you want to.
Well, no, but they will put up a phone number.
Oh, yeah.
And you will be able to call
right.
and get okay. those pieces
right.
calling.
This album right here is called Avantagan, which means traditional Armenian music. This was recorded live at the San Francisco World Music Festival. We played it two festivals for the San Francisco World Music Festival. So anything you hear from this that are live, they're live concerts.
All of them.
Second one is this one here, and that was recorded live at California State University, Fresno.
And later on, you will get to see a little piece from one of those Fresno concerts.
Yes. And this one here, this album, was recorded live at California State University, Northridge. We played four different times at Northridge. And this one here, which is our last album, but we'll be doing more later on. This was recorded at Cal State Fullerton in Orange County. So every one of these albums basically are unique because there are songs in these albums that have never been recorded. And one unique one is this one. Why? We met this blind violin player, Mr. Guzelian, in Istanbul, Turkey.
Baron Murad,
yeah. And I said to him, do you know any Armenian songs? He says, you know what? I remember one song when I was 12 years old. I went to a wedding and it stayed with me. Uh-huh. And I said, well, I took him to the studio. Mm-hmm. He brought his violin. He played it on the violin, brought it back. I wrote the music out. And we dedicated it to him. Sarkis.
No, Muradin.
Muradin Sepasya Haygagan Hale. Mm-hmm. And Hale, for those of you who know what it is, it's the men's dance originally that was a warrior's dance, and they would hug each other and dance around a bonfire to give each other strength to go into battle. And later on, it became a secular dance for the men. And it's a very, everybody holds everybody close.
And later on.
And later on, we let the ladies in too. So now the ladies and the men dance the holly together.
And also Barbara sings also, you know, like
we forgot. Well, she's the vocalist of the ensemble.
Yeah, that's the one we forgot to say.
Yes.
I am.
And of course, she didn't learn Armenian. I'll let you talk about that.
Well, when I was young, we only spoke English in the house, and I spoke English with all of my grandparents on my mother's side, my father's side. The only Armenian I heard was when our grandparents' generation got together, and they would speak in Armenian. And when I was about 16 or 17, I thought, I have to learn Armenian. And so, Gamats, gamats, par parov, hartsusi, asinchke nishanage, sehan, asinche sehan, asinche ator. Yet sharanaket sivor, minchevi makich bahayen gurnam hosil, pites cheska sahayen hoselov.
That's okay.
And let me, for you kids out there, that don't you think that you can learn Armenian? She's an example. She's fourth generation. If you have the will, you will learn the Armenian language, because we need to save it. It's disappearing. And if you kids out there don't learn and study the Armenian language, in a couple of generations or three or four generations, it's going to be gone.
Yeah, it's,
and we're going to lose another part of our culture. So please, I beg all of you, if you have a desire to learn Armenian, don't say, well, my mother doesn't speak Armenian, my father doesn't speak Armenian.
Mine didn't.
You know, her parents didn't speak Armenian. I mean, they spoke Armenian, but they didn't teach it to her. Mm-mm. So please, this is from Sarkis, myself and my wife, please, you kids out there, we have to save, just like we tried saving our music, you have to start saving our history and our language. It's very important. Shatgarevorevor. An answer of our higher and chef was it as a girl, a minute love Jamanagna for serving because she's serving then make me the Gorson Senec, but I'm in a keretzik. Each pesos him, Hagagan Lezun, were tarred off Mezigabatkani. So, Hantrim, Sarkisin.
And I want to say something. I came across some wonderful books. My first book of Armenian words and my second book of Armenian words printed through the AGBU. And it's a wonderful way for parents who don't know Armenian to teach themselves and their children basic words. And I have gotten copies of both of these books for all the young ones in our family. And it is one way that you can start little by little. It's very good.
And the second way, since most of you kids are computer literate, programs to help you learn Armenian and make it so simple, you'll have fun with it. And believe me, you will learn it because most of you young kids are very smart. You're smarter than our generation.
You are.
So they will have an opportunity because they're all computers, better than we do.
Actually, what's bad, sort of, they come here, many people, they come young, 8, 10, 12 years old, they speak perfect Armenian. During the time, they lose it.
Yes.
Oh.
Because
the parents, they say, we're living here, they should learn English more. They don't speak.
But they can learn English
the other way. My wife, when the twins were born, my older son, we sent him to Armenian school. We're lucky.
Mm-hmm. You are.
He went to Armenian school. But the twins, when they were born, there was no school around there anyway. They were little boys, 5, 6 years old. They went first time.
Yeah.
They went to school. All the kids, they're playing. They don't speak English at all. And the others, they don't speak Armenian. They used to come to home. They say, Mom, you know, Asunk Hayer and Chenki there. You know,
Chenkosir. Yeah.
2-3 months later, they start coming home. Mom, you know, I'm hungry. I'm going to eat. My wife.
Good.
The opposite. Ishmael, you know, among Chaskets and where they used to say, oh, Mama Nankler and Chicky there.
Uh-huh.
I ran the sink for Haskana.
Yeah.
And they kept the idea like that.
That's good right. For good for
that,
her.
That was another way.
Yes. Yes.
But it is another way.
Well, you know, it's you know, another language doesn't hurt.
No.
You know, in my time when I was young, living in the country, whatever, We speak four or five languages.
Yeah. I know, most Europeans
do. Survival was a routine, like, not because I was smart. That's how it was.
It was, yeah. You expected to speak that many.
But also there's another thing that has nothing to do with sort of an order. Somebody, Japanese, they used to speak Armenian and so forth. You know, during that war, there were prisoners in Fresno. They were... Everybody was surprised. Look, it's Ayarenkhosi. I mean, we speak four or five languages. Nobody says it's not Ayarenkhosi.
Right.
Same thing with singers. The guy halfway knows he can't pronounce the song. He sings Armenian to collect money, right?
Right.
This guy, the singer Armenian, sings Arabic, French, English. Beautiful. Perfect.
Right.
They don't say bravo.
I know.
It's expected.
It's expected. Yeah.
Well, I don't.
Yeah.
When you notice those things, sometimes, you know, it's bad.
Right, you know. Right.
Anyway, but it's, you know, I was going to ask you something.
Well, I just want to say one more thing about the album.
Okay.
This album here, okay, Passage to Armenia, won a Grammy. And we're the only group in the United States that took first place in the International Grammy Awards with that album. So we're proud of that, too. It's not to brag, but to mention that our Armenian music does have significance in the world today. Mm-hmm. It's not just for the Armenians. It's when we do our concerts, it's for the general public. It's not just for the Armenians. And Barbara explains each song before we sing it. She sings it, and we explain the instruments, the different instruments that you see in the pictures here to the audience, for those that don't know what they're seeing. And the uniqueness part is our beautiful Armenian instruments and the master musicians that play them. So that's the draw. Just like if a Russian group came from Russia here, how many Russians are there? There are not many, but the general public goes to see them. Well, that's what happened with us. The general public came and supported us. That's why we're still here 26 years later.
You know, I remember, speaking of this, the first concert that I sang, we were at the Mark Taper Forum, I believe, here.
Yeah.
And it was very nice concert, beautiful music and so on. And the minute we were finished, this man of color came running up the aisle. And he said, "What kind of music is this? It's beautiful. I've never heard it. I'm a professor at I don't know what college, blah, blah, blah." And he thought it was marvelous, and he had never heard it.
Yes.
And that's another thing. We need to not only share with our own people, of course, but others need to know who we are and what a rich culture we have.
Very rich.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, your first instrument was clarinet, right?
Yes.
When did you start to play the oud?
Well, when I was in Las Vegas, you know, we would have the shows on the lounges. So a lot of times I would send for an oud player to come from Los Angeles because no oud player there. And sometimes I'd call and say, "Oh, I can't come. I'm sick, or I got another job, this and that." So I said, "Well, gee, I better learn to play ouds in case someone can't make it. Not that I'm going to play oud all the time." So I taught myself. And I there were films at that time of different oud players. I watched their fingers. I watched their strumming. And gamats, I was able to play the oud because I have a music background. And then, and the oud, basically, the neck, is the same fingering as viola. If you play viola, not violin, but viola, the spread of your fingers on the fingerboard is the same. So I said, then I realized that, I can play this very good because I'm going to use the same fingering on the viola, from the viola. That was made it so easy for me. And then all I had to do is learn my strumming, and I started playing good in the different shows when somebody could not come. Yeah, that's how, you know.
And in Fresno, oud was, you know, like...
Oud, clarinet, dumbag, kanun.
Kanun, yeah.
That was like...
And back east, too. Back east also, in New York, in Washington, D.C., in Boston, in Providence, you know.
It was so strange. In Boston, they wanted me because they had a band, two ouds, clarinet, this and that, and they wanted like bouzouki sound.
Uh-huh.
Right. And I used to play strings anyway. I had the electric mandolin.
Yeah.
And I used to play it. They used to love it.
Yeah, oh, like kanon,
like playing kanon or something.
Oh, I did not know that.
And I remember the first song. It was making me so laugh. Սիրուն աղջիկ օրեգուր Աբատս կիդիլեցու
And Ուդի Հրան song, you know. Սիրուն աղջիկ սիրուն յար Ուրբոր երտաս հետետան Արանց կեզի չեմ գրնար Ուրբոր երտաս հետետար And Ուդի Հրան, the blind master musician of the Armenians that was born in Istanbul, Turkey, and his brother was Ուդի Բողոս, they both were born blind.
How sad.
And they're the ones that brought the oud to the United States. Prior to that, it didn't exist in this country. So from 1950, when Ուդի Հրան first came to this country, he brought several Caribbean ouds. Caribbean, only Caribbean was the master oud maker.
It was also expensive, I remember.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it was, you know, but each time Hrant came over, he brought another oud, and all the young ones that were interested started buying them and started learning oud. You know, and so the other thing I was going to tell you about the East Coast, which many of you in California don't know, if I may, the Armenians, after 1930, decided that they wanted places to take their families and relax and have a type of vacation. So there were two main areas. One area was the Catskill Mountains of New York. The second place was, if you wanted to go to the ocean, it was Asbury Park, New Jersey. So either the Armenian families would go to the mountains in Catskill, or they would go to Asbury Park. These became the two main places. So in the Catskill Mountains, a lot of times, there were five Armenian hotels. When you came up this winding road,
Catskill in Japan,
oh
Lord, my Lord.
Catskill in Japan, oh Lord, my Lord. Akchik Badesa, yeah, that's a good Lord. Akchik Badesa, yeah, that's a good Lord. Yegurya Takmezi, Chamishma Damkezi, Yegurya Takmezi, Pachlava Damkezi, Chara Jiji Akchik, Hampur Madurinzi, Chara Jiji Akchik,
Bachik Madurinzi.
Bachik Madurinzi.
So
as you came up the winding road to Tannersville, New York, first one was the Hotel Armenia. Then you went a little further up. There were cabins that you rented. It was called the Bajakian's Cabins. And then a little further, you went to Varbet's place, which is on the left side. And then you went to the Waverly Hotel that had music on the weekends with Shakar Mary and Ուդի Հրան and the Hopizar band from Philly. Mm-hmm. And then you went a little further, Shady Hill Hotel. And every weekend, it was full. So it was a wonderful experience for the Armenians and their families.
That sounds great, John.
Now, if you went to the shore, you went to Asbury Park. And there were two hotels. One was called the Van and one was called the High. And if you put them together, you got Hivan, but which means animal anyway. But we had great times there. The bands from Philly would come and play at different weekends. And great oud player George Mogadishian of the Gomidas and Vospigyan band would play. Mm-hmm. And it was a great between Armenian music and this wonderful chef they call Varbed. He would make Armenian food. So you had Armenian food, you had Armenian music. And then you had different bands coming and playing. And I went there with Chookasian, who is the master oud player on the East Coast. And I played with him. I was very honored to play with him for 9 years. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, he got sick and he passed away.
Well, but you know, it was wonderful. Not only did families go there, but all the young kids.
Yeah.
All of them. They all went and they hung out together. And I am so sorry that I was not born at that time and in that place.
Yeah.
I would love to.
And Sarki knows there were all kinds of nightclubs on the East Coast where the Armenian bands played. And we played in Greek nightclubs. We played in Armenian nightclubs. And it was a ball. Let me tell you something. In California, you didn't have anything like this. But if you were back east, like Sarki and I, it was the golden age of Armenian music bands.
Yeah.
Because in each band, you had four or five pieces plus a singer. You had oud, you had kanun, you had violin, you had clarinet, you had dumbag, you had guitar, and the vocalist. Mm. And it was such a full, powerful sound, you couldn't help yourself but get up and dance, you know?
and the Vospigyan band.
There's also Barsamian, right?
Abu Barsamian band. Yeah, yeah. He's the one that played more Armenian music with saxophone and clarinet and oud and so on. It was fun. Yeah, it was fun music. And basically for circle dancing, you know.
When I came to California, you were in Fresno, maybe. I don't know, you know. It was shish kebab band.
Right.
There was Barites.
Yes.
Oh, that's Barites.
And there is Dolmas or something. Three or four bands only. Wow. They were all about similar.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
There's round circle.
Yes.
Clarinet, two ouds sometimes. Yeah. Come back.
Right, right.
But I played with them a long time. Yeah. Later on, I played at a nightclub by myself. It's a history. I don't want to talk about it, but some other time we talk. I play oud.
I know you do. And you played very nicely too.
Well, anyway.
Yeah, you did.
I was going to talk about it some other time. What I'm doing now, I'm changing the guitar to oud.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm playing the guitar like a oud.
Really?
Yeah, now I'm going to take the frets out. I'm going to make it.
Yeah.
But I'm sure. See, the style is different. People, they don't know.
Right.
You're a oud player, you know, the style of the mizrab.
Right.
Very different.
If you don't know how to play, it doesn't sound like oud.
Right.
Right.
No.
That's a technique that you have to learn.
Yes. Yeah. But, you know, Viken Najarian, the oud maker and repair person, Viken Najarian, his family from Lebanon made ouds. Well, he has created a flatback, fretless oud. You know, that you plug in and it's
electric boot.
Electric boot, yeah.
But it's not curved.
They sell it. They have it.
It's
also expensive. But when it sounds all right, like sounds more than a little guitar like
that. Yes, it does.
It does.
But it's still nice sound.
Yeah, but you should know how to play it anyway.
Right, that's it.
But if you're a chocolate oud player, it's very nice not to have all of that in your way.
Yeah, the round back.
I have one here, but that's to be fixed. It's
Well, I'll give you Viken's number. He'll fix it for you. He's the master craftsman, Anaheim.
Anaheim. Oh,
he'll fix it.
He's
perfect.
Very good.
Yeah. Anyway.
Anything else you want to add?
Yes. This past year, unfortunately, has been difficult for everybody in the United States and the world. And we lost a couple of Armenian concerts. So we're hoping that we can regain this concert. So if you are an organization or an art center or an Armenian organization and you want to have a fundraiser and help us save Armenian music and culture, we'd appreciate it if you invite us so that we could do a concert for your community. Whether it's here or anywhere in the United States, we can travel anywhere.
Yes.
So we'd be saving our Armenian culture and music, and you'd be helping us, and you'd be raising money for your organization. So it'd be a good combination. So please, in the future, we would appreciate an invitation to continue our Armenian cultural group and preserve our music.
Okay. One thing I forgot to tell you, we had a program in Fresno.
Yes.
Armenian Teletime.
Time.
For 17 years.
Right.
Chaderechenki there.
Yes.
In Fresno and San Francisco separate.
Right.
Because it was no connection then, no satellite, no cable, nothing. You had to go into the station. And John Chookasian helped us a lot. For 17 years, he was helping us as much as he could.
Thank you. Really.
Thanks for coming by.
Well, because the thing was that what you were doing was, again, in a different way, helping us preserve Armenian music and culture. And God bless you for doing that and your family, because you have incorporated your family into this milieu, and they need to be applauded too, just like you, because without them, you could not continue. So bravo to the boys and girls
even now, you know, if it wasn't for my sons, my grandson,
yes,
he's doing all this technical work and so forth. What else I can wait till? What else I can want from God?
Exactly.
Well, we'll sing and play, and they can do the technology.
Right, right.
That's good. But there's one thing. Sometime during the program, you're going to show a little clip.
Oh, yes.
It's a six-minute clip of how we come into our concerts during the second half. And it is an Armenian wedding procession. And there's a lot of singing and dancing, and the people always get involved. They just can't sit down.
Well, Fresno State, California University, Fresno, State University, Fresno, invited us to do a concert. And I contacted PBS, and PBS was very interested. So PBS came and filmed our entire concert. This is only 6 minutes of it to show the people that are not familiar with what we do, mm-hmm. how we sound, and so on, to give you a better idea of what we do when we're on stage.
Yes.
So there are six different pieces on here, and it totals 6 minutes. So if you'd be kind enough to allow us to show that to you, we would like to show you our PBS concert. Oh, by the way, when it was shown, PBS broadcasted it from Modesto down to Bakersfield, and over 2 million people, several times, over 2 million people saw our Armenian music and culture mm-hmm. on PBS.
Yes, it was good.
Thank you. Thanks again.
You're welcome.
Շնորհակալություն։ Գնարեք մի քիչ երկարեցինք։ Դեստվինք հաջորդ անգամ ցտեսություն։
Ցտեսություն,
շնորհակալ եք։ Այո։
Tune in Sunday at 5 p.m. for an enchanting evening of traditional Armenian music. That's the Chookasian Armenian Ensemble, a production of Valley Public Television, Sunday at 5 p.m.
We are unique in that we make it a point to present the music of Eastern Armenia and the music of Western Armenia. And it is rare, if at all, that you will hear this music together on the same stage. Piece that we'd like to play for you is especially dear to me. It is called Mesho Achchik, the girl from Mush, and my great grandparents came to the United States from Mush in 1896. So you will hear the song A Girl from Mush, sung by a girl from Mush. Sure.